बिस्मिल्लाहिर रहमानिर रहीम। अस्सलामु अलैकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम फरीहा असगर, एसएस कंप्यूटर एट डिवीनल पब्लिक स्कूल एंड इंटर कॉलेज साहिवाल। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू चैप्टर नंबर 2, डेटा टाइप्स, असाइनमेंट एंड इनपुट आउटपुट स्टेटमेंट्स। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग टुडेज लेसन, आई वॉन्ट टू टेक सम प्रीव्यू ऑफ प्रीवियस कॉन्सेप्ट्स। स्टूडेंट्स, In this chapter, you have learnt about the character set of BASIC. The character set of BASIC consists of numbers, alphabets, and special characters. Alphabets include uppercase and lowercase letters. Numbers include from 0 to 9. And some special characters are also included in the character set of BASIC. Reserve words. Students, you have learnt about reserve words. That reserve words are also called keywords, and the keywords have special meaning in BASIC, and we cannot use these keywords as variable name. In our last lectures, we learned about variables. Variables are named memory locations in the memory that are used to store data and results. Students, we have also learned about some rules for writing a variable. Then we learned about the types of the variables, that is numeric variable and string variable. Numeric variable contain integer variable. An integer variable ends with a percent mark and it contains 2 byte space in the memory. Student, these integer variables store whole numbers in it. Numeric variables can also store floating point numbers. For this, we use single precision in BASIC. Single precision variables ends with exclamation mark and it stores 6 significant digits. Students, it can actually store 7 digits, but only 6 digits are accurate. And it contains 4 byte space in the memory. If we want more accurate digits, then we use double precision. A double precision variable ends with a hash sign and it contains 8 byte space in the memory. Other type of variable is string variable. Students, string variable contains strings, that is sequence of alphanumeric characters, and a string variable name ends with a dollar sign. And it contain as many space in the memory as the length of the string. Students, in our last lecture, we have also learned about constants. Constant is a quantity whose value cannot be changed during program execution. Students, value of the variable must be changed during the execution of the program, but the value of constant doesn't change during the execution of the program. It remains same in the whole program. Constants also have two types, numeric constants and string constants. Numeric constants include integers, single precision constant and double precision constant. Integer constants are whole numbers, either these are positive numbers or negative numbers. Single precision constants include fractional values, and single precision store 7 digits. For more accuracy, we use double precision, and double precision constants store 17 digits, in which 16 digits are accurate. Students, in our last lecture, we also learned about the indications of single precision and double precision. A single precision constant consists of 7 or fewer digits. It uses exponential form E, and a single precision constant ends with an exclamation point. In the same way, a double precision constant stores 8 or more digits. It uses exponential form D and it ends with number sign hash. Another type of constant is string constant. A string constant is a sequence of alphanumeric characters enclosed in double quotation marks. Students, when we enclose the name of a person or a sequence of characters into double quotation, then it becomes a string constant. The maximum length of a string constant is 255 characters, and our today's topic is BASIC commands. Students, in this chapter number 2, we will learn about some commonly used basic commands. But today, we will only discuss these 3 commands. Number 1, auto command. Number 2, clear command. Number 3, CLS command. Let's discuss these 3 commands one by one. First one is the auto command. Students, this command automatically generates line number in an increasing order each time the enter key is pressed. Students, we learned in our last lecture that every instruction of basic begins with a line number. जब हम एक प्रोग्राम लिखते हैं बेसिक के अंदर तो उसकी हर इंस्ट्रक्शन में हमें लाइन नंबर देना होता है एंड ईच इंस्ट्रक्शन स्टार्ट्स विद अ लाइन नंबर. दिस वर्क परफॉर्म्ड बाय ऑटो कमांड फॉर अस. दिस इज द सिंटैक्स ऑफ ऑटो कमांड इज ऑटो लाइन नंबर कॉमा increment. Another syntax is auto dot comma increment. Students, here line number shows first line number. Here line number shows the number of first line, starting line, and increment. The syntax of auto command is auto line number comma increment. Another syntax is auto dot comma increment. Student, this auto command is very useful for us because it relieves us typing the numbers again and again and it automatically generates line numbers for us. Students, in the syntax of auto command, line number specifies the starting line number of the program, whereas increment specifies the subsequent increment to the previous line number. If we are not giving the value of line number and increment in the auto command, then the default value of line number and increment is 10. The default value for both line number and increment is 10 if we are not giving any value with the auto command. And in the syntax of auto command, the period can be used as a replacement for line number to indicate the current line. If increment after the line number is omitted, the last increment specified in an auto command is assumed. अगर हम increment को omit कर देते हैं और line number के बाद हम increment नहीं देते, तो इससे ये होगा कि auto command जो है वो last increment को specify करेगी. If auto generates a line number that is already being used, then an asterisk sign appears after the number to warn that any input will replace the existing line. In this case, students, just press enter key immediately after the asterisk saves the line and generates the next line number. Students, if we want to terminate the auto command, for this enter control and break or control C. In this way, GW Basic will return to the command level. There are some examples of auto command. First example is auto 100, 20. Students, here 100 is the line number and 20 is the increment. This command auto 120 generates line numbers as 100, 120, 140 and so on. You can see that in this case, first line number will be 100 and it can take an increment of 20 in each line number. So, first line number is 100, second one is 120, third one is 140, 160 and so on. This is another example of auto command, auto. Here, line number and increment is missing. We are not giving increment and line number here. So, in this way, I told you earlier that auto command takes the values 10. Auto command में अगर हम line number और increment miss कर देते हैं, अगर हम increment और line number नहीं लिखते, तो इस सूरत में auto command जो है वो default value लेगी और default value जो है वो line number और increment की वो 10 होगी. It means that first line number will be 10 and it can also takes an increment of 10 every time. So this auto command generates line numbers 10, 20, 30, 40 and so on. Auto, comma, 50. Students, you can see here that line number is missing here. only an increment of 50 is given. So in this example, auto command generates line numbers starting from the line number specified in the last auto command with an increment of 50. Second command is clear command. This command sets the value of all numeric variables to 0 and the values of all string variables to null. Students, ये तमाम numeric variables की value को 0 कर देगा और तमाम string variables की value को null कर देगा. Okay? And 0 जो है वो value होती है but null means nothing. Its syntax is clear. Third one is CLS command. Students, CLS is the short form of clear screen. So this clear screen command is used to clear the screen. It simply erases all the things, all the text and graphics on the screen and becomes the screen clear for us. Its syntax is CLS N. Here N is optional and it may contain these three values 0, 1 and 2. If we give 0 in CLS command, 0 means if we are not giving any value. If the value of N is 0, then in this case the CLS command clears the screen of all text and graphic. It means screen pe jo bhi text and graphics hain wo sab erase ho jayengi, clear ho jayengi. If we give the value of N 1, now CLS command it clears only the graphics which are present on the screen, and if we give the value 2, then in this case CLS command clears only the text present on screen, and its examples are CLS, CLS, 1. Students, let's see how these commands work. Students, here you can see the main screen of GW Basic. Now, we can apply different commands. First one is auto command. So, if we write here auto and we are not giving here line number and increment, then by pressing enter key, you can see that it generates first line number 10. Again press enter key, now it generates line number 20. Now I am pressing enter key again, you can see that it generates line number 30. Student, जैसे कि पहले हमने discuss किया that auto command में अगर हम line number and increment नहीं देते, then it takes the default value 10. Okay, first line number भी 10 होगी और ये increment भी 10 numbers का ही लेगा. Now let's take another example of auto command. Now, for example, if we write auto 100 comma 20. Now, by pressing enter key, you can see that it generates line number 100. First line number is 100. And by pressing enter key again, it generates second line number, that is 120, giving an increment of 20. Press enter key again. Now it generates 140 with an increment of 20. So students, is tarah se auto command jo hai wo aapke liye line numbers generate kar deti hai aur aap jo hai us line number ke samne apni commands, apni statements, अपने प्रोग्राम की इंस्ट्रक्शंस जो है वो आप लिख सकते. नाउ राइट हियर क्लियर. ओके, वी राइट हियर क्लियर कमांड. नाउ प्रेस एंटर की. स्टूडेंट्स, यू कैन सी दैट दिस क्लियर कमांड इज अप्लाइड. नाउ इफ वी वांट टू इरेज दिस स्क्रीन, वी वांट टू इरेज द कंटेंट्स ऑफ द स्क्रीन, then we will use clear screen command, CLS command. Type CLS here and press enter key. Students, you can see that the contents of the whole screen are erased now. Students, in this way you can easily use the commands CLS command, clear command and auto command in your program. So students, in our today's lesson, we have discussed about auto command. that this auto command automatically generates the line numbers. The syntax of auto command is auto line number comma increment. This line number shows the starting line number, other value shows the increment in the line number. So students, this command is very helpful for us. It relieves us from typing the line numbers again and again. Second command which we have discussed today is the clear command. Students, this clear command sets the value of all numeric variables to zero and all string variables to null in your program. Third one is CLS command. CLS stands for clear screen, and this command, as its name suggests, that the CLS command is used to clear the whole screen. Okay, we can erase the whole screen, and if we want to erase the text only, or just we want to erase the graphics only, for this we use the value of n in its syntax. We can give value 0, 1 or 2. So students, that's all about today's lesson. Students, you have to solve the assignment now. Question number 1, what is the purpose and syntax of auto command? Differentiate between clear command and CLS command. Thank you so much, students, and Allah Hafiz.